Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video we will see how to set up C or C++ on VS Code. For that we will see the following steps. First we will install the MinGW compiler to run C and C++. Then we will install VS Code. In the third step we will connect both VS Code and C, C++. And in the last step, we will run our first program on VS Code. So let's see. Let us first install the MinGW compiler. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type MinGW compiler and press enter. Now the first website, you need to click on it. Okay, here is the official website. I'll also add this link in the description of the video. Click the download button. Now the download will start. We have downloaded the exe file. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. Now the setup started. Click install. MinGW will get installed in the following location. Keep it as it is and click continue. Now the setup started. Let's wait. Click continue. Now the following is visible. Here and select the packages you need to install. First I'll select the developer toolkit. Click mark for installation. Do the same for base, mark for installation, and for G++ mark for installation, and Objective-C also. Click and mark for installation. Okay, rest keep as it is and go to installation. Go to installation and click apply changes. Click apply. Now it will download the packages. It will take some good amount of minutes based on your internet connection. It's written all changes were applied successfully. Click close. Now we have installed it. Okay. Go to the location. It was in C drive. Remember, here it is, MinGW. Go to bin. Go here, right click and copy the path. Minimize. Go to start, type environment variables. Edit the system environment variables and click open here. Now, click environment variables. Here, click path. Double click. Click new. Right click and paste the same path. After that click OK. OK. And the last OK. Now we have successfully installed it. Let us verify. Go to start. Type CMD. Click open. Now let us verify the installation. Type G++ space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Here it is. It's visible. That means we successfully installed it. So guys, we successfully installed the MinGW compiler. Now in the second step, we will install VS Code on Windows 11. Let's start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type VS Code and press enter. Now the official website is visible, code.visualstudio.com. Click on it. Now here the version is visible, download for Windows. Click on it to download. Now the download started. Here it is. Here is the version. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. Now click I accept the agreement and click next. Here is the location where VS Code will get installed. Click Next. It will create a Start menu folder. Click Next. Additional task, if you want a desktop icon, you can select this. But I don't need it, so I'll keep it as it is. And click Next. Now the summary is visible. Click Install. Now the installation started. Let's wait. The VS Code setup completed. Click Finish and it will launch on its own because the checkbox is by default clicked. I'll click Finish. So VS Code opened for the first time. So guys, we successfully installed VS Code. Now in the third step, we will connect both VS Code and C++. For that, go to here, Explorer. Now click Open Folder. Now let's say on the desktop, I'll create a new folder. I'll write Amit Project, okay? Select this and select Folder. Now we have our folder inside VS Code. Right click, click New File. I'll create my new C program, let's say demo.c. .c is an extension for a C program. For C++, you can type CPP. Okay, I am creating for C. Now, since you created a C file, it will automatically show you what you need to install to connect. Okay, it is recommended to install the C++ extension pack. Okay, click Install. Now, this is officially provided by Microsoft. It is installing. That's it, we have installed it because uninstall is visible. Now go here again and click here. Now write your first C program. So now we will type the printf method in C. Whatever you'll add within this will get printed. I am just typing my name. Okay, return 0. Go to File. Click Save. Okay, now since we already installed the MinGW compiler, we don't need to do anything, just run it. To ease your work, go here, type code runner and click on it and install it. We already installed it, so it's visible here. You just need to install it. What will happen? This will allow you to right click, run it, run code. This run code is visible because you installed code runner. So I'll just run it now. Run code. Here it's written Amit Thinks printed. I told you it will get printed. Now you can also check GCC is visible. Now what is this? This is your compiler. Remember, we installed MinGW compiler also. You can also check here if you want. Okay, what I'll do, I'll go to here and click terminal, new terminal. Here also you can check GCC. G++ space --- version. Now the same will be visible which we saw before. Okay, that means we successfully installed it. And this was the output. So guys, we successfully ran a C program in VS Code. Let us understand this quickly. This is the standard input output header file. Okay. This allowed us to use the printf. Int main, what is this? This is the main function from where the execution of any C program begins. Here I already told you, this line will print the string Amit Thinks to the console. Here, return 0, this line ends the main function and returns 0 to the operating system. That is indicating that the program finished successfully. Guys, if you want a free C and C++ tutorial, refer the links in the description of this video. Thank you for watching.